We've already shown you how to add a single image to your post or page, but it could be you want to add a gallery. There are lots of great gallery plugins you can use, but the native WordPress gallery feature is pretty solid, so let's take a look at that. To start, I'm going to get rid of Mario here, so I'm going to click on Mario and just remove him. And then I'm going to make a space for my gallery. Typically, I just create a blank line somewhere and say, okay, my gallery is going to go in here. The way it starts is similar to adding a single image. Click on Add Media. And in here now, you have all the images you've uploaded, or you can drag new ones in. But up in the upper left, it says Create Gallery. So we'll click on Create Gallery. The site doesn't really change much, but now instead of clicking each one, you can click to select. You'll notice the little checkboxes appearing in the upper right. So we can choose a handful of images. Okay, we'll choose all those. We've got those selected. We'll say Create New Gallery. And now here's the images in our gallery. We can add captions right in line here. We can drag and drop to rearrange in whatever order we want. And then on the right-hand side, we have some options. What do you want to link to? Do you want to link to an attachment page, a media file, or nothing? For this one, I tend to like the media file. There are ways to enhance how that works. Jetpack has some good features, but this basically means they'll see a small version of the image and they can click and get a big version of the image. How many columns do you want? 3 is pretty standard. Do you want to randomize the order? You can. How big? Thumbnail's typically good. You could show huge images, but that makes it more difficult to work with. And then is it a thumbnail grid or just a slideshow? And a grid is pretty common. So we'll insert our gallery. You'll see our gallery shows up right away there. If we view the post here, we'll save our draft and preview it. Let's go check out our post here now. You'll see when we preview our post, we have this gallery in here. It's got them perfectly spaced. It's mobile responsive. It does a nice job. And if we click any image, we see the big version of it. So going back to our post now, suppose you want to edit this, because if you click anywhere on this, it's just one big thing. You can't really work with it, but it gives you the option to edit or remove. And so we'll go back and edit. And then in here, you can drag and drop again like you could before. My computer's lagging a bit. There we go. Or you can add to gallery, meaning I want to add more images to it. So we go back out here and say, okay, I'm going to add this one and this one and this one. And add those in. You'll see they show up at the bottom here. We can drag and drop those where we want. Anytime we can change the settings here, update the gallery, and the gallery is updated with those new changes. So it's really a pretty slick system, very easy to use, a quick way to make a photo gallery on any post or any page that you want. So give it a shot, and if you have any questions, leave a comment and let us know. Thanks.